guys, this is another video from Industrial Shields. In this video, I showed one of our demos. This demo has a panel PC based in Raspberry Pi called TouchBerry Pi. Then we have a M-Duino 42 based in Arduino Mega, a stepper motor, an encoder, and also a stepper driver. Apart of that, we have a panel control that is simulating some inputs and outputs with some LEDs and switches. The TouchBerry Pi has a dashboard developed with Node-RED. As you can see, the dashboard has some switches and sliders. In one side, we have the Node-RED application. In the Node-RED application, we have a dashboard that is controlled for a web server, and also we have a TCP/IP server that will receive and send the data to our M-Duino 42. Into the M-Duino 42, we have also a TCP server and a TCP client. The M-Duino is in charge to collect the data from the switches and send it directly to the TouchBerry Pi through Ethernet using TCP/IP. Also, he will be in charge to collect the data from the dashboard through also Ethernet, and will communicate with one side with the motor stepper driver and also with the LEDs. Also, the M-Duino is collecting the data from the encoder. As you can see here, we have some inputs. In this case, these cables come from these switches. So as you can see, the internal LED of the M-Duino 42, it's turning on and off depending on the switches. In other side, we have the encoder that is directly connected to these DIN rail connectors, and it's directly connected to the M-Duino inputs. Also, we have some outputs to control. In this case, we have the outputs coming from the M-Duino outputs directly to the LEDs. And in the other side, we also have some outputs to control the stepper driver. Here we have the stepper and encoder control. We have two switches. One is in order to enable and disable the stepper motor, and also we have the other switch that is to control the direction of the stepper motor. Also, we can control the speed, changing the frequency of the pulse that will be sent to the stepper driver, and also we have the feedback from the encoder. Apart of that, we have the general outputs. In this case, we have two digital switches that will be just to power on and power off the green and the red LED. And also, we have the option to generate an analog signal directly to our LEDs, and we can control this slider to control the intensity, actually is the PWM of the signal. Let's see how the other outputs are working. As you can see here, I can change the red LED and the green LED, changing the switch here. Also, I can modify the PWM. I don't know if it's well appreciated in the video, but in real life, it's very clear how the PWM is changing. Also, we will see how the inputs works. Here, I have some switches. As you can see, in the top left side, of our dashboard, we have the first control of the first switch that, as you can see, is changing on off. Also, I have a switch counter for the switch number 2 that, as you can see, is increasing properly. The last switch, we have a timer on it that will be counting every time that the switch is turned on. And as you can see, it's increasing as expected. Thank you very much for following us, guys. Hope that you have enjoyed this video and you have found interesting this demo. See you in the next video. Have a nice day. Bye bye.